when you are living and following, flowing with the master, you don't need to renounce dharma for the sake of moksha, moksha for the sake of dharma. Because the idea you carry about dharma is not the ultimate dharma. It is not dharma at all. Forget about ultimate. It's not dharma at all. When there is a person, moksha, alive sitting in front of you, to describe dharma every moment to you, just go with it. You don't need to even renounce what you may think. If you are just flowing with the master's experience and flow, and by his words and by himself along with him, you are not renouncing dharma. Even if you renounce all the ideas of dharma, whatever you think as dharma, even those ideas are taken away from you. You are asked completely to do something opposite. Even then, the very renunciation of dharma does not happen in you, as the dharma itself is expressing itself directly in your life through a person who is established in the ultimate dharma and moksha. So with this word, Shankara just somehow relaxed into the deep love, bhakti, the guru bhakti. So he stopped or relaxed from presenting further argument, because any argument Shankara will present for this thought trend will be disrespectful to the guru bhakti, his own guru. So he just rested.
Let me start one by one. Did you see one revelation? When moksha and dharma overlaps on each other or pushes each other, the being and doing, if there is more being, less doing, it is called pleasure. If there is more doing, less being, it is called wealth, artha.
Wow, the whole life science is over. And if completely being takes over, moksha. If completely doing takes over, dharma. Be zero D is moksha, D zero B is dharma, D higher than B is wealth, B higher than D is pleasure. The aphorisms of existence. This is what is Brahma Sutra. Understand, aphorisms of existence. How you exist, how you can exist. I can say, it's not debate between Shankara and Vyasa. Gossip between Shankara and Vyasa. I'll dig out the sacred secrets from the sutra. See, as the cause is bliss, effect is abundance. Maybe abundance can be considered as maya, illusion. No, it is not. As the cause creates effect without any gap, without any reason, and can never be separated, as an innate experience and tendency, the cause is inbuilt with effect. bliss is inbuilt with abundance, abundance cannot be maya. Then finally whole thing boils down to whether dharma is important or moksha is important. Naturally everybody will say moksha only is important. Then why dharma and moksha are two different? Then it boils down to moksha can never be tasted unless a person in whom moksha and dharma has merged in your life transmits it to you. Dharma can never be lived unless a person in whom the moksha and dharma has become one teaches you. Moksha can never be tasted unless he transmits, the guy who experienced both together in him, both are merged in him. Same way, you can't live dharma unless he teaches. When I use words, it can be considered as dharma. When I push energy, it can be considered as moksha. If you are sitting and grasping words, you are grasping dharma. If you are sitting and grasping energy, you are grasping moksha. But both are from same source, where both have become one and the same. In some body, both have become one. Only that body can transmit even one to you. Because it can be transmitted only from a body where both have become one, you don't need to renounce one for the sake of other. If you catch his energy, naturally you will go with his words. If you go with his words, naturally you will catch the energy. That's all. I think today you guys cannot have a debate. Or do one thing, Vyasa team transcribe the Vyasa's thought flow. Shankara's team transcribe Shankara's thought flow. And both of you try to repeat those same arguments in your understanding. As per your understanding, try to repeat the same arguments. Maybe you will have more deeper understandings. Understand? Today, I have not only given the sacred secret for debate, I have given the complete thought flow for debate. The very thought flow for debate is given. Very thought flow for the debate is already presented to you. You just intensify those words as you understand. I can give you these three sacred secrets. Is abundance and bliss different? Is dharma and moksha different? Is the master is the source of both? You can honestly debate. Sometime you can have a different view. You can say, I can understand master is moksha, but I don't think he is dharma. You can say, you can present your own arguments. You can say, no, I think master is dharma, he may not be moksha. Or you can say, I think he is neither both, dharma nor moksha. Or you can say, he is both, but he transmits only one, dharma or moksha. Or you can say, no, he is both and he transmits both. You can take any flow. The sacred secret can be, he is the source of dharma and moksha. Does he transmits both? Who gets which? Or who receives which? Who receives what? You can explore. You can debate. Send me the results of your debate. Then I'll further explore into this thought trend. Let Vyasa and Shankara bless all of us to understand their very thought flow. Let them bless us to experience their very energy flow, the ultimate Brahma Sutras, the ultimate aphorisms of existence, the ultimate existence itself. I bless you all to achieve, live, experience, express, radiate, and share the eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.